News update for InfoLive TV, this is David Oman. Israel's Ministerial Committee for Symbols and Ceremonies on Wednesday decided the war with Hezbollah in the summer of 2006 will now be officially called the Second Lebanon War. IDF Chief of Staff Gabi Ashkenazi warned the Security Cabinet on Wednesday that it will take time in order for the IDF to reach the necessary level of preparedness and implement lessons from the Second Lebanon War. Syrian President Bashar Assad, in an interview to French TV, said Wednesday that his country was no longer supplying weapons to Hezbollah. Assad added that Syria was opposed to secret negotiations with Israel, such as those that took place during Sharon's term of office, and supports open peace negotiations. According to reports in the Turkish press, at least five senior Iranian officers have disappeared in the last few days in Turkey and are estimated to have defected to the West. One of the five is said to hold the rank of Brigadier General. Sources in the Justice Ministry said Wednesday that Attorney General Menachem Mazuz would consider directing Finance Minister Avraham Hirshzon to suspend himself or go on leave of absence following the police investigation into the minister's suspected embezzlement. The Israeli Ministry of Absorption is fighting the brain drain in the medical profession, encouraging Israeli doctors abroad to return to Israel to work and do research by offering each one some $60,000 upon return. 18 flights are due to land in Israel with thousands of English fans who will cheer their national soccer team in its match against the Israeli national team on Saturday. Israeli hotels and pubs have prepared special fare and huge amounts of beer. Israeli Home Command and Rescue Services hold the largest ever drill simulating terrorist attacks and chemical warfare. Today on InfoLive TV, the extraordinary story of Dr. Lavi and advanced heart transplants in Israel. And finally, the Tel Aviv fashion scene, the hottest designers, hairstylists, and fashion lines in the Spring-Summer 2007 collections.
InfoLive.tv, the world's first television channel broadcasting on the web in four languages, live from Jerusalem. If you want a direct look at Israel and the Middle East, InfoLive TV is there, at the heart of the information, at the heart of history, at the heart of Israel. InfoLive.tv